ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो शर्षिभ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरयितः प्रज्ञान घन प्रत्यगत्तो ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि। नारायणं पद्मभुवं वसिष्ठं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्रपराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौडपदं महान्तं गोविन्दयोगीन्द्रमथासि शिष्यं श्रीशङ्कराचार्यमथासि पद्मपादं च हस्तामलकं च शिष्यं तन्तोटकं वार्तिककारमन्यानस्मद्गुरुं सन्ततमानतोऽस्मि। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यद्ब्रह्मगोचरविचित्रतमः प्रभावात् संसारधीजनित ुखमभूज्जनस्य यद्ब्रह्मधीजनितसौख्यमभूच्च तस्य तं रुक्मिणीसहितकृष्णमहं नमामि। यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरीसहोदरापमहत्पदं तमहमाशुहरिं परमाश्रयीजनकचाङ्कमनन्तसुखाकृतिम्। सो वाट् इस् मिथ्यात्वं, वि आर् लुकिङ्ग् एट् दट् सेक्शन् as to what is mithyatvam. The Tikakara said, idani mithyatvam nama jnana nivartyatvam ajnanam nama anadyupadanam iti vivakshaya vyakhyanantaram abhipretya ajnanasya lakshanantaram aha. What is meant by this mithya ajnana? In the earlier lakshana of ajnana we saw mithyatvi sati saksha jnana nivartyatvam. While being mithya, that which is directly countered by jnana and removed by jnana, that is called as ajnana. And thereby ajnanasya lakshanam mithya jnana padena uktam. The second definition of ajnana is introduced by the Tikakara as anaditi lakshanantaram, another lakshana, another definition. So mithyatvam, mithya shows that it is removed by jnana. So the nanj in ajnana is jnana nivartyatvam, virodarthe nanj. And what is ajnana? Ajnana is upadana karana. So that upadana karana which gives to samsara karya and which is countered by jnana, when the jnana is stronger enough to overpower ajnana, then the ajnana karya will also have nasha along with the karana ajnana. That is the idea with which Bhagavan Bhashyakara said mithya jnanam. मिथ्याज्ञान निमित्तः अयम् लोकव्यवहारः। नाउ ज्ञानेन अनादीति, सो अनादीति वी हैव सीन दी एनालिसिस ऑफ दैट, परीक्षा ऑफ दैट लक्षण। नाउ अनादि उपादानत्वे सति मिथ्यात्वं वा लक्षणम्, द सेकंड लक्षण इज अनादि उपादानत्वे सति मिथ्यात्वं वा लक्षणम्। So upadana karana, when did it come about, this ajnana? It is anadi ajnana. It's an upadana karana, but unlike mrut which has come up in time as karana, upadana karana for ghata, this ajnana has not come in time. It has always been there. Therefore anadi upadanatve sati mithyatvam va ajnanasya lakshanam. So ajnana is mithya, but it is anadi as well. That is another way to look at this lakshana. Tika, yasya adihi, meaning utpattihi, na vidyate tad anadi. That which does not have an adi beginning मीनिंग व्हाट इज बिगिनिंगलेस इज कॉल्ड एज अनादि तथा च अनादित्वे सति उपादानत्वे सति इत्यर्थः मीनिंग दैट व्हिच बीइंग अनादि इज आल्सो उपादान कारण दैट इज मेंट बाय अनादि उपादानत्वे सति सो इन दि अनादि उपादानत्वे सिंगल समास देयर आर टू वर्ड्स अनादित्वे टू वर्ड्स आर देयर मीनिंग अनादित्वे सति उपादानत्वे सति इत्यर्थः सति मिथ्यात्वं लक्षण मिथ्याज्ञानपदेन उक्तमिति पूर्वेण अन्वय देन दि लक्षण इन दि रत्नप्रभा द सेम अर्लियर sentence part of the sentence which will make this sentence complete as what is the lakshana for therefore you have to bring that and complete the sentence asmin lakshane sakshat padadikam na niveshaniyam however the word sakshat which was there in the earlier lakshana whereby some ativyapti was taken away that is not necessary here therefore for laghava you have to keep दि लक्षण विदाउट दि साक्षात् पद दैट इज मेंशन्ड हियर अस्मिन् लक्षणे साक्षात् पदादिकं न निवेशनीयम् वाय सो बंध इच्छा प्रागभावयोर् अतिव्याप्त्यभावाद् इति भावः द अतिव्याप्ति विच वॉज देयर अर्लियर एज टू बंध एंड इच्छा इच्छा प्रागभाव देयर इज नो अतिव्याप्ति इन दिस केस वाय सो Asmin, why so? So earlier we have seen this Ichhapragabhava. Ichhapragava will have Ativyapti in the Nayayika Ekadeshi Matha. Because if you just say Jnana Nivartyatvam, Jnana Nivartyatvam, the Jnana Janati Ichhati Yathate. In that sequence, the Nayayika Ekadeshi says that once there is jnana, then that itself takes away Ichha Pragabhava. Ichha is not needed to take away Ichha Pragabhava. Ichha is born out of jnana and some Vishaya jnana will take away the Vishaya Ichha Pragabhava and therefore Ichha is born. So that is also jnana nivartya. इच्छा प्रागभाव ज्ञान निवर्त्य देर वॉज अतिव्याप्ति बट इट इज नॉट साक्षात ज्ञान निवर्त्य देर फोर ज्ञान इच्छा प्रागभाव साक्षात सॉरी इट इज साक्षात साक्षात निवर्त्यते बट अज्ञान निवृत्ति द्वारा ज्ञान निवर्त्य बंधे अतिव्याप्ति निराशा साक्षात इति सो हियर द मिथ्यात्व मिथ्यात्व सती वॉज एडेड वाई बिकॉज देर वॉज इच्छा प्रागभाव विच वॉज गोइंग अवे साक्षात बाय ज्ञान हियर वॉट इज सेड इज साक्षात इज नॉट नीडेड इन द केस ऑफ साक्षात आदि हैज बीन मेंशन्ड सो साक्षात ज्ञान निवर्त्यत्वम दैट इज नॉट नीडेड इन द सेकेंड लक्षण सो नॉट ओनली साक्षात बट साक्षात ज्ञान निवर्त्यत्वम सो ज्ञान निवर्त्यत्वम इज नॉट नीडेड बंधे इच्छा प्रागभाव अतिव्याप्त्य भावात् बिकॉज वंस यू हैव सेड इट इज मिथ्या एंड इट इज व्हाट इट इज अनादि बंध इज आल्सो अनादि एंड उपादानत्वे सति हैज बीन एडेड वंस उपादानत्वे सति इज सेड बंध इज नॉट उपादान बंध इट इज नॉट एन उपादान कारण बंध इज कार्य सो साक्षात ज्ञान निवर्त्यत्वम इज नॉट नीडेड बिकॉज ऑल बंध इज डेफिनेटली साक्षात ज्ञान निवर्त्य बट इन द सेकेंड लक्षण दैट इज नॉट नीडेड बिकॉज देर इज नो अतिव्याप्ति सो साक्षात इत्यादि विच वॉज एडेड एंड मेन्शनड अर्लियर सो आदि आदि पदेन वॉट एवर वॉज मेन्शनड अर्लियर टू टेक अवे अतिव्याप्ति दैट इज नॉट नीडेड इन दिस लक्षण एंड इच्छा प्रागभाव Even if you add Sakshat, Ichha Pragabhava is also Sakshat Jnana Nivartya. But Jnana Nivartyatvam itself is not needed here. So there is no Ativyapti in Ichha Pragabhava also. It is not Jnana Nivartya. Why? In the Lakshana, it has been said it is Upadana Karana. It is Upadana Karana and it is Mithya. So Ichha Pragabhava is not Mithya. इच्छा प्रागवा इज कंसिडर्ड एज व्यावहारिक सत्त हैविंग व्यावहारिक सत्त देयरफॉर देयर इज नो अतिव्याप्ति एंड देयर इज नो नेसेसिटी ऑफ एडिशनल दलाज देयर फर्दर ब्रह्म निराशार्थम इति व्हाट हैज बीन सेड आफ्टर द लक्षणा बीइंग गिवन द टू लक्षणास आर गिवन एंड देन ब्रह्म निराशार्थम मिथ्यात्वम इति परीक्षा ऑफ द सेकंड लक्षण व्हाई मिथ्यात्वम हैज बीन मेंशन्ड इन दि अर्लियर लक्षण मिथ्यात्वे सति साक्षात् ज्ञान निवर्त्यत्वम इन दि सेकंड लक्षण अनादि अनाद्युपादानत्वे सति मिथ्यात्वम वा लक्षणम अज्ञान इज अनादि इट इज उपादान कारण नाउ ब्रह्म इज आल्सो अनादि डेफिनेटली ब्रह्म इज अनादि नॉट ओनली इज ब्रह्म अनादि इट इज अनंत एज वेल अज्ञान विल हैव अंत ऑन ज्ञानोत्पत्ति अज्ञान विल हैव अंत बट इफ यू से अनादि अनादित्वे सति देन लक्षण वंदला अनादित्वम इज आल्सो देयर इन ब्रह्म उपादानत्वे सति उपादानत्वम इज आल्सो देयर इन ब्रह्म बिकॉज अविद्या अलोन इज नॉट उपादान कारण वेन यू से उपादान कारण ईश्वर इज उपादान कारण अभिन्न निमित्त उपादान कारण देयरफॉर ब्रह्म इज अभिन्न निमित्त उपादान कारण उपादानत्वम इज आल्सो देयर देयर बाय देयर विल बी अतिव्याप्ति इन ब्रह्म वेर एज यू वॉन्ट टू गिव लक्षण ओनली फॉर अज्ञान ब्रह्म नॉट बीइंग अज्ञान देयर इज अतिव्याप्ति देयरफॉर मिथ्यात्वम हैज टू बी एडेड सो ब्रह्म निराशार्थम मीन्स टीकाकार सेज ब्रह्मणि अज्ञान लक्षणस्य अतिव्याप्ति निराशार्थम इत्यर्थः टू टेक अवे ब्रह्म मीन्स नॉट टू टेक अवे ब्रह्म टू टेक अवे दि definition of ajnana overreaching into brahma for that reason mithyatvam has been added brahma is not mithya brahma is satya therefore there is no ativyapti mrudadi nirasartham anadi iti then why not say upadanatve sati mithyatvam that should cover the ajnana lakshana no anadi has to be mentioned why because mrut clay is upadana karana for ghata and it is also In the broader perspective of Shastra, it is also Mithya. What is Mithya? Mithya is that which has dependent reality also, but here we are looking at Ajnana Lakshana. So, Mrut being Mithya and being Upadana also, there will be Ativyapti in Mrud Ityadi. Whatever is the Vyavaharika Karana. Vyavaharika, another word for Vyavaharika is Mithya. Vyavaharika Satta means Mithya. It is not Sat, but it is not Asat also. Satchet na Badhyeta, Asatchet na Pratiyeta. Therefore, Pratiti being there, it is not Mrudadi, Prapancha, all the Karanas here specifically. In the prapancha are not asat because of pratiti and since they are jnana nivarti as well they cannot be asat they cannot be sat sorry they cannot be sat why there is badha jnanena badha thereby they are mithya however they are themselves not ajnana they are ajnana karya so there should be no लक्षण अतिव्याप्ति इन अज्ञान कार्य विन यू आर योर लक्ष्य इज अज्ञान देयरफॉर अनादि हैज टू बी एडेड मृत इज नॉट अनादि मृत इज अ कार्य एवरी कार्य इज आदिमत इट इज नॉट अनादि देयरफॉर देयर विल बी नो अतिव्याप्ति इन मृदादि अविद्यात्मनोः संबंध निरासार्थम उपादानत्वे सति इति देन व्हाई नॉट से अनादि अनादित्वे सति मिथ्यात्वं अज्ञानस्य लक्षणं व्हाई नॉट यूज ओनली दोस टू टर्म्स व्हाई ऐड दिस उपादानत्वं अविद्यात्मनोः अविद्या एंड आत्मा अविद्या एंड आत्मा जीवात्मा आर बोथ अनादि आर दे मिथ्या सो दे आर नॉट मिथ्या बट दे आर अनादि एंड व्हाट मिथ्यात्वं निरासार्थं अविद्यात्मनोः संबंध सॉरी नॉट Avidya and Atma sambandha nirasartham. There is a there is an ekadesha anvaya here, so therefore a little confusing. Avidyatmano sambandha nirasartham. So this nirasa will have anvaya with sambandha, but not with avidya and atmana. So avidya atmanoho nirasartham is not the anvaya. Avidya atmanoho yaha sambandha tayoho, yaha sambandha meaning avidyayaha atmanaha madhye yaha sambandha sa sambandha api anadihi tasya nirasartham tasya tasmin ativyapti nirasartham, that is the idea. So there is an ekadesha anvaya here in this samasa. So avidyatmanoho sambandh nirasartham upadanatve sati iti. So avidya and atma both are anadi. So what is the sambandha going to be between them? Between avidya and atma there is some sambandha. What is that sambandha? Definitely mithya sambandha. Why? Because avidya is mithya. Although atma is satya, avidya being mithya, there cannot be satya sambandha between avidya and atma. So what is the sambandha? It cannot be asat also. Then what sambandha is there? Between mithya and sat, sambandha is going to be mithya. So there is a mithya sambandha also. Both avidya and atma are anadi. The sambandha is anadi. The sambandha is mithya. Therefore, if you say anaditve sati mithyatvam ajnanasya lakshana, then it will have ativyapti in avidya atma sambandha. Therefore, to take away ativyapti there, upadanatve sati iti. So what has been said? Upadanatve sati. It is also an upadana karana. Avidya is an upadana karana. Atma is an upadana karana. But sambandha between them is not an upadana karana. Therefore, there will be ativyapti nirasa by adding upadanatve sati. So the second lakshana is anadi upadanatve sati mithyatvam va ajnanasya lakshanam. Tika. Brahmani ajnana lakshanasya ativyapti nirasartham ityartha, that is what we saw when with Brahma nirasartham. Evam uttaratra vijneyam. Similarly, when sambandha nirasartham has been mentioned, you have to understand that it is sambandhe ajnana lakshanasya ativyapti nirasartham ityartha. Sarvanubhava rupa pramanena. Sarva anubhava rupa pramanena. Adhyasa siddhi muktva. So having mentioned this adhyasa, what is adhyasa? It is sarva loka anubhava, anubhava siddha. Ajnaha aham, karta aham, this is all mithya pratyaya. That mithya pratyaya, pratiti, anubhava, jnana is there for each and everyone. But that jnana is not yatharta jnana, it is ayatharta jnana, it is brahma. And that is how you can understand adhyasa. That is one way to look at adhyasa. Sarva anubhava rupa pramanena. Anubhava being jnana is a pramana. However, the pramana in this case is to establish adhyasa. You cannot deny that adhyasa bhana is there. That is all it is meant by saying anubhava pramana. It does not mean it is yathartha jnana, meaning conclusion need not be yathartha. But the bhana being there cannot be denied. Whether that bhana is in keeping with reality or not is a different story. But pratiti is there. Pratiti does not make it real. But pratiti cannot be denied. That is meant by sarva anubhava rupa pramanena adhyasa siddhi muktva. Adhyasa is definitely there. And what is being said really? You have Brahma Anubhava. So there is Yathartha Jnana of Brahma. If you have to inquire into it, what is being said is that you have Anubhava, which is Pramana. Why? Because you know that it is Brahma. When Shastra says you are not a Karta and you have Anubhava of Kartrutvam, then that Anubhava of Kartrutvam establishes Brahma. So the yathartha jnana of Brahma, of ayathartha jnana, that I have ayathartha jnana, I have yathartha jnana regarding that. So it's a little convoluted if you look at it that way. So whatever makes it easy. सर्वानुभव रूप प्रमाणेन अध्यास सिद्धि मुक्त्वा शब्द प्रयोग रूप अभिलापेन च अध्यास सिद्धिरिति भाष्याशयम् उद्घाटयति संप्रति इति. सो नाउ व्हाट इज बीइंग डन इज दैट शब्द प्रयोग रूप अभिलापेन विद दी शब्दास आल्सो नॉट ओनली पॉइंटिंग आउट अनुभवा बट भगवान भाष्यकार इज शोइंग दी शब्द प्रयोग आल्सो देयर इज अ शब्द प्रयोग थ्रू विच अध्यास कैन बी एस्टैब्लिश्ड. इन दी भाष्य इटसेल्फ ही हैज शोन दैट द शब्द प्रयोग देयर व्हाट रत्न प्रभाकर इज डूइंग इज ही इज शोइंग लोक व्यवहार मेंट अनुभव देयर फॉर लोक व्यवहार शोड दी सामान्य अनुभव वेर बाय एवरीवन नोज दैट देयर इज अध्यास. दे मे नॉट नो इन डिटेल बट सामान्यता दे नो दैट इफ दे हैव नो हाउ ऑफ द शास्त्र दैट आई एम नॉट कर्ता बट आई कंसिडर माई सेल्फ एज कर्ता. आई एम नॉट देह बट देह धर्मास इन यूजेज आई कंसिडर देम टू बी माइन दैट इज भ्रम. सो नाउ संप्रति रत्न प्रभाकर से संप्रति अध्यासम दृढ़यितुम् सी वाइट पेज. ओके आई नीड टू रीलोड लेट मी क्लोज एंड ओपन दी ऐप अगेन. Is the screen visible now?
No.
No?
No, yes. Yes,
it is G.
Yeah, it came.
Okay. So, samprati iti. So, samprati adhyasam dradayetum. Abhilapati. So, what is the way in which you can understand this adhyasa? Adhyasa is definitely there. अहम इदम मम इदम. सो अहम इदम मम इदम दिस इज शब्द था यूज बाय एवरीवन. द फ्रेज इज यूज बाय एवरीवन. आई एम दिस पर्सन बिलोंगिंग टू दिस फैमिली. आई एम दिस जेंडर एंड सो ऑन. सो दैट इज एन अध्यास. एंड मम इदम ऑल्सो दिस इज माइन दैट इज माइन. ऑल दीज क्लेम्स आर ऑल्सो वर्ड अध्यास. First there is aham, ahanta, and there is mamata. Tika, sampratiti, and then nanu vyadadhyadhyasa prathamikatvad bhashye pratipadayitavyaha. Katham aham idam ityadhyadhyasa pratipadanam ityataha adhyatmiketi. So there is an objection to this. This aham and mama are adhyasa. Why does Bhagavan Bhashyakara start with aham and mama? First, Pancha Mahabhuta Shrishti is there. Then the Sharira is at the end. Pancha Mahabhuta Shrishti is there. Then there is Panchikarna. This Panchikrita Mahabhutas give rise to their Mahabhutas. So they give rise to Bhautika Prapancha. So Bhautika Prapancha is mentioned in the Bhashya, Adhyasa Bhashya by Yushmat Pratyaya. Then why do you start with aham? Why don't you start with this idam is adhyastha on oneself. Why do you start with aham? So, vyadadi adhyasaha, the Akasha etc. is adhyasa in Brahma. So that is the first adhyasa, because Panchamahabhutas are created much before the Jiva Sharira is created. So there cannot be Ahanta unless one associates with the Sharira, which is going to be at the end. Panchamahabhutas are created in the sense they are adhyasa in Atma, Brahmatma. Why not talk about that adhyasa? Because in Krama, it is first. So, Prathamikatvad, Vyadadi, Vyad is Akasha. Akashadi adhyasa, adhyasa Prathamikatvad. Nanu Vyadadi adhyasa, adhyasasya. So, nanu, so this should be read as adhyasa. Nanu Vyadadi adhyasasya Prathamikatvad. Bhashe Pratipadetavya. Otherwise, no, it is right. Vyadadi adhyasa pratipaditavya. Bhashye. Why? Prathamikatvad. That is how it should be read. So, the adhyasa and shashti is also there. Tasya prathamikatvad. Because the Vyadadi adhyasa is first. Or Vyadadehe prathamikatvad. Even if it is not adhyasa, Vyadadehe prathamikatvad. Tasya adhyasaha pratipaditavya. Bhashye. First, that not only first, it should be discussed. Why do you go to Aham Adhyasa? Katham Aham Idam Ityadi Adhya Ityadi Adhyasa Pratipadanam Ityataha. Why do you go to Aham Idam Mama? All this. So Aham Idam Mama Mama Idam Aham Idam Mama Idam. Why do you go so far? That is the question. Ityataha Adhyatmiketi. The Mukti is not for Prapancha. You need Mukti. You, the Jiva, needs Mukti. So everyone has to look at oneself and inquire into one's reality. So I am a Jiva. I am a Samsari Jiva. How will I become Mukta? By knowing Adhyasa, which is centered around me. Adhyatmika, Atmani Adhi. Adhi, Adhyatma is Saptami Arche there. Atmani, related to Vishaya Saptami. Atmani Vishaye, Mama Vishaye, Mama Swarupa Vishaye, I have to do inquiry. Not regarding the Samsara and Samsara itself being Adhyasta. So my inquiry should start with me. And it should really end with me also. Therefore, that is of primary importance. Always you start with what is pradhana. The subsidiaries, all the surroundings can be covered in passing. The Shastra also talks about Srishti. It talks about Vyadadi Srishti also. Not for the sake of the Srishti being real. That is not the Tatpare Vishaya. The Tatpare Vishaya is Atma and Aikya with Brahma. The Vyadadi Srishti is talked about only for the sake of explaining this Sharira which I find myself to be associated with and to be. Therefore, the Tatpare is not in the Vyadadi Srishti. The Tatpare is in Aikya finally, but Aikya cannot be established unless I know that I am separate from the body-mind-sense complex. And that body-mind-sense complex has come about from Vyadadi. Therefore, Vyadadi Srishti has been talked about in the Shruti. So, the Ratna Prabhakara says, Adhyatmika Karyadhyase Adhyaseshu. So, there is a little trouble in reading this. The Shakara has vanished there. Adhyatmika karyadhyaseshu ahamiti prathama adhyasaha. This is the first adhyasa. From my perspective, what is the adhyasa? I cannot see the prapancha unless I have indriyas. Indriyas I cannot have unless I have sambandha, tadatmya sambandha with the sukshma sharira, and which cannot be possible, meaning the Vyadadi Pratiti is not possible. The world outside cannot be cognized unless my indriyas have a place to rest. My sukshma sharira has a place to rest. Which has to be the stula sharira. The bhoga ayatana. स्थूल शरीर. सो आध्यात्मिक कार्याध्यासेषु अहम् इति प्रथम अध्यासः. देयर इज अ कार्याध्यास. दिस कार्य इज सुपर इम्पोज ऑन माई सेल्फ ब्रह्मात्मा एंड देन आई टेक इट टू माई सेल्फ. दैट इज द फर्स्ट अध्यास विदाउट विच आई कैनॉट सी एनीथिंग एल्स. आई कैनॉट डील विथ एनीथिंग एल्स. न च अधिष्ठान आरोप्य अंशद्वय अनुपलम्भात् न अयम् अध्यास इति वाच्यम्. अधिष्ठान आरोप्य अंशद्वय अनुपलम्भात्. इन द केस ऑफ अहम् आई एम दिस एंटिटी. डू यू सी टू व्हेन यू से दैट आई एम अ मैन, आई एम अ वुमन, आई एम दिस काइंड ऑफ अ पर्सन, दैट काइंड ऑफ पर्सन, वॉट एवर यू टॉक अबाउट, डू यू सी टू थिंग्स देयर? अध्यास इज पॉसिबल ओनली व्हेन देयर आर टू थिंग्स. द टू थिंग्स आर नॉट कॉग्नाइज, दे आर नॉट इंटेंडेड ऑल्सो. व्हेन यू टॉक अबाउट यूर सेल्फ, यू टॉक अबाउट यू एज अ सिंगल एंटिटी. You are not introducing your spouse along or your child along with yourself. You are introducing yourself. That yourself is an individual entity. It's a singular. Ekavachana. So, dvayoho aunshayoho. So, there cha adhishthana and aropya. On the adhishthana, when there is something aropya, aropa is done of the aropya. Aropitum yogya, aropya. That aropya, when it is adhyasta in the adhisthana or on the adhisthana, then alone you can call about talk about it as an adhyasa. In the aham, you say aham iti prathama adhyasa. How can aham be an adhyasa? Because aham is a single entity. There are no two, as in there is no adhisthana and there is no aropya. You should not say so, says the siddhanti. Nachavachyam iti nachavachyam. Therefore, na ayam adhyasa, this aham is not an adhyasa. Why? Because you don't cognize two. You cognize only one, you intend one. Therefore, it is not an adhyasa. Siddhanti says you should not say so. Why? We'll come back to that. Tika, adhyatmika karyadhyasa viprayina bhashye aham idam ityadi dvitiya adhyasa pratipadanam. Now, the adhyasa that is being discussed in another manner is taking into account that aham is the first adhyasa. Earlier, with loke vyavahara, it was mentioned. Now, adhyatmika karya adhyasa viprayana. It is the karya adhyasa. The shariras are adhyasta onto oneself. Sharira is adhyasta, or sharira traya also is adhyasta into oneself. And there is a tadatmya sambandha there. इति अभिप्रायेण भाष्ये अहम् इदम् इत्यादि द्वितीय अध्यास प्रतिपादनम्. दिस सेकेंड एक्सपोजिशन ऑफ अध्यास इज यूजिंग दैट आइडिया ऑफ कार्याध्यास एंड कार्याध्यास इज अहम् इज द फर्स्ट इन द सीक्वेंस देयर. देन ओनली यू कैन टॉक अबाउट अनदर अध्यास मम इदम् और नॉट माइन प्रपंच आउटसाइड. ऑल दैट कैन बी डिस्कस लेटर ओनली व्हेन यू हैव अध्यास विद द शरीर. देयर इज अ तादात्म्य संबंध. तथा च द्वितीयस्य प्राथमिकांशिक प्राथमिक अध्यासं भाष्यस्य आर्थिकार्थस्वरूपं स्वयं पूरयति इति भावः. सो द्वितीयस्य प्रथम आकांक्षिकत्वात्. देयर इज एन आकांक्षा बिकॉज देयर इज अ डिपेंडेंसी ऑफ एवरीथिंग एल्स ऑन दिस फर्स्ट अध्यास. देयरफॉर दिस इज बीइंग टॉक्ड अबाउट फर्स्ट. स्वयमेव पूरयति नायम अध्यास इति. So, nayam adhyasa. Therefore, this is not adhyasa. You should not say. What is, why so? Idam rajatam ityatra rajatasya adhyasattva vat. So, idam rajatam. In the shukti rajatasthala, this shell is not seen, but you say this is silver. Idam rajatam. इत्यत्र रजतस्य अध्यस्तत्ववत् अहंकारस्य अध्यस्तत्वे अधिष्ठान आरोप्य अंशद्वयं वक्तव्यम्. इन दि रजतस्थल व्हेन यू लुक एट शुक्ति रजत, शुक्ति इज नॉट सीन बट इदम अंश ऑफ दि शुक्ति इज सीन. दैट इदम अंश इज सेपरेट फ्रॉम दि रजत. इदम अंश इज नॉट रजत, देयरफॉर इट इज एन अध्यास. सामानाधिकरणम इज देयर बट देन देयर आर टू अंशास. वंस you understand, or even if you do not understand, someone else does, there are two. So here, what are the two? you are not known idamamsha, and in aham, at least in aham, there is no idamamsha and rajatamsha, like there is no separate shariramsha. When you say aham, there is only one entity. Therefore, idam rajatam ityatra rajatasya adhyastattvat ahankarasya adhyastattve adhisthana aropya amshadvayam vaktavyam. You should talk about two things now. Tachana sambhavati, why aham ityatra niramshasya ekasya dvai rupyana anubhavad iti shanka nirasa iti shanka granthartha. The Puropakshi's intention is to say that there is a vaishamya between drishtanta and darshtanta. Your drishtanta is shukti rajata, where idam rajatam two amshas have been shown. Here, what are the two amshas? This has been discussed earlier in a different manner, but now adhyasa is being discussed anew with a karya adhyasa, prathama karya adhyasa perspective. Therefore, this doubt is going to come up in another way. So the Puropakshi is taking another approach, or a different Puropakshi. So there are no anubhava of two. When you say aham, there is no anubhava of two. Whereas idam rajatam, when you say this entity is silver, so there is thisness as a separate entity, and silver which is seen, that is a separate entity. At least two amshas are there. In the statement also it is there. So shabdata, you know that there are two. But here there is no such anubhava when you say aham. There, ayash shabdartho lohapindaha, shanka granthartha. Then back to the Ratna Prabha. Ayodhati iti vata aham upalabhe iti drigdrishyamshayor upalambhat. So the answer given is iti na vachyam. Iti na cha vachyam. You should not say so, as two amshas are not there. Idam rajanta, in idam rajanta, it is not clear to you. However, I'll show you another example, says Siddhanti. Ayodhati. When you say ayodhati, are two things known there? Ayodhati is what? The iron burns. The iron does not burn. Iron does not have the capacity to burn. But when it is heated up, the heated iron rod burns. Or it is a, let's say, square or circle, a spear or whatever it is. Whatever shape is there, that shape is of the iron. When you heat it up, it glows red. What glows red really? The fire is glowing. The iron is not glowing. The fire glows red. But we say there is red ball of fire. The fire is not ball shaped. Only the iron is ball shaped. Similarly, the fire burns, the iron does not have the capacity to burn. It is not its property, it's not its quality, but still we say the iron burns. So ayodhati iti vata, in that example, do you say that the iron burns? Ask the Siddhanti. The iron doesn't burn, otherwise it should burn always. Does it burn even after cooling down? Or non-heated iron, does it burn? No. Itivat aham upalabhe. Similarly, I see something. I am cognizant. I hear, I see, I taste. When I say this, it is not Atma I which is hearing, speaking, tasting, seeing. It is not the Atma. It is like the iron rod burning. So there is an adhyasa. There are two components there which have as do become one. Iti drigdrishya aumshayo ho upalambhat. So if you say there are two aumshas, but there is no anubhava, you have to show two aumshas. If the Puropakshi says you show me two aumshas, there is no anubhava of two aumshas. There is. Drigdrishya anubhava is there of two aumshas. I see something else, but I see that seeing there is drig and drishya bheda is there. Now this is different from what the Puropakshi is really asking. Puropakshi is saying aham. In the aham pratyaya, not aham upalabhe, that I attain something, I see something, I gain something, that is not being asked. aham pratyaya, in that aham pratyaya, can you show me two amshas? There is no anubhav of two amshas. Whereas Siddhanti is answering smartly as aham upalabhe, dridrishyaya viveka is showing. There are two amshas there. Idam padena bhogyaha sangataha. So when you say aham idam, there idam padena. So he explains, when you say aham idam, I am this entity, what is that idam showing there? It is like ayodahati. It is like aham upalabhe. When I say aham upalabhe, there aham idam pratyaya is included. And through that example, you can know what is that idam also. Idam is like that aham upalabhe. There is a karma there. There is a drishya bhogya padartha. Similarly, there is bhoga sadhana. There is bhoga ayatana. All that is what? That is also drishya. So, idam padena bhogya sangataha. Uchyate. When I say aham idam, and that idam can be anything. I am a man. What is a man that? That is known through idam pratyaya. But there is a mix-up. So that which is bhogya, when I say aham idam upalabhe, there also that idam means something else, bhogya, drishya. And when I say aham idam, there also that idam is really bhogya. Tika. Ayash shabdartho lohapindaha. So lohapinda, the lump of iron in some shape, is meant by ayah shabda. But when you say ayo dahati, dahana kriya is not being done by ayaha. So ayo dahati ityatra agnihi ayah pinda, agnir ayah pinda sampruktataya avabhasate. The agni itself appears to be dahati ityatra agnihi. Agni hi ayah pinda samprukta taya avabhasate. The fire itself, as though burning through the iron, appears to be burning. The iron appears to be burning by the connection with Agni. So Agni burns, but Agni itself appears in the iron as though iron is burning. That is the idea there. Ayah pindha tu agni samvilatataya tena agni nishtha dagdhrutvam ayah pinde avabhasate. So what happens is agni hi ayah pinda sampruktataya avabhasate. As though connected with the iron, the agni appears. And then ayah pindha tu agni samvilatataya. So then there is some sambandha there. But there are two entities. Therefore, tena agni nishta dagdhrutvam ayav pinde avabhasate. The dahana shakti is not then in ayav pinda. It is there in agni. But due to this tadatmya sambandha, where there is bheda and abheda also, it is bheda sahita abheda. That bheda sahita abheda, tadatmya sambandha between ayav pinda and agni, makes the agni appear in ayah pinda as though burning, as though the ayah pinda is burning. So here, tena agni nishtha dagdhrutvam, the dagdhrutvam which is agni dharma, ayah pinde avabhasate, dharma appears in ayah pinda in the other dharmi. So it is an adhyasa. Ayah pinda nishtha चतुष्कोणाकारत्वम अग्नौ तस्माद् अयः पिंड अग्नि रूप अंशद्वयम् अनुभूयते यथा. सो इन दैट एग्जांपल देयर आर टू अंशास एंड तादात्म्य संबंध इज बोथ वेज, अध्यासा इज बोथ वेज. सो द अग्नि धर्म अयोदहति, देयर अग्नि धर्म ऑफ दहन इज सीन इन अयः पिंड. एंड देन अदर वे अराउंड ऑल्सो व्हाट हैज बीन सेड इज अयः पिंडः तु अग्नि संविलततया. सो संवलिततया मीन्स अगेन अदर साइड ऑल्सो देर इज एन अध्यास. द आकार ऑफ द अग्नि इज नॉट रियली द आकार ऑफ द अग्नि. द आकार ऑफ अग्नि सीन इज द आकार ऑफ द अयः पिंड. सो द चतुष्कोणादि, आकार, चतुष्कोण आकार, इट इज रेक्टेंगुलर शेप्ड आयरन पीस, बट द अग्नि अपीयर्स टू बी रेक्टेंगुलर, विच इज नॉट ट्रू. तस्माद् व्हाट हैपेंस, तस्माद् अयः पिंड अग्नि रूप अंशद्वयम् अनुभूयते यथा, एंड ड्यू टू दैट तादात्म्य संबंध बोथ वेज, अध्यास बोथ वेज, देयर इज इंटरचेंज ऑफ धर्मास एज दो दे अपीयर टू बी, एंड द वे देयर इज एन अनुभव ऑफ टू एंटिटीज बीइंग मिक्स्ड अप इवन व्हेन यू से अयोदहति. इफ यू यूज दैट फ्रेज, इट डजंट मीन दैट यू डू नॉट नो द डिफरेंस. You know the difference between the two, but still you say ayodhati. The iron burnt, the water burnt. Water does not burn. There is hot water, it burnt. So you say hot water burnt. Water burnt me. I had a water burn. It is the agni which burns. I had a steam burn. The steam, of course, steam cannot be there without heat, but water can be there without heat. When you say water burns, the water doesn't burn. The fire in the water. The dahana belongs to the agnihi, not the jala. Tatha, similarly here, tatha aham upalabhye ityatrapi chidatmadyahankara sampruktataya avabhasate ahankaropi chidatmani samvalitataya tena jadya chetanatvadikam api vyatyasena avabhasate. So dharmadhyasa is there in the case of atma and the drishya also, drik atma and the drishya also. Tatha aham upalabhe ityatra, in that case also, when I cognize something, what happens? Chidatma di ahankara sampruktataya, the or it can be chidatma adyahankara sampruktataya, that's a better way to look at it. There is chidatma di, does not make much sense there. So chidatma adya ahankara sampruktataya. So ahankara is the adya adhyasa, therefore it is pratham adhyasa. That is how it, you can read it to make sense of this adi here. Otherwise it can be read as adya, but if it is adya, there has to be akara there, or it can be adi ahankara also, or it should have been chidadi atma ahankara sampruktataya. Whereby chit and adi can go together as to dharma. Otherwise, I am unable to make sense of chidatma adi ahankara sampruktataya. Or it can be taken as samadhar adhyasa also, where instead of atma adi can be added. But in the exemplified, there is only atma to be talked about, asmat pratyaya gochara. Therefore, I'll say chidatma and ahankara sampruktataya. There is tadatmya sambandha, and therefore avabhasate ahankaropi. What happens? Chidatmani samvalitataya avabhasate. Avabhasate has an anuruti there. So there are dharmadhyasas both ways, which we have seen at length. Tena jadya chetanatvadikam api vyatyasena avabhasate. Since dharmi tadatmya is there, there is also dharma tadatmya. But vyatyasena, धर्मास आर इंटरचेंज अक्रॉस धर्मीज. तस्माद् अहम् इत्यनेन आत्म अहंकार रूप अंशद्वयम् अनुभूयते. या ओके, दैट्स अनदर वे. चित, सो चित कैन बी टेकन एज सेपरेट, एंड देन आत्मा, आत्माद्यहंकार, अगेन आदि पद आई कांट मेक सेंस ऑफ, लेट इट बी. सो हियर तस्माद् अहम् इत्यनेन आत्म अहंकार रूप अंशद्वयम् अनुभूयते इति परिहार ग्रंथार्थ. We saw Shankha Granthartha. Now Parihara is what? The sum up of Parihara is, even if you say two are not seen, but Ahankara is definitely seen as separate from Atma. Therefore, there is an Anubhava of two Aumshas. Drik Drishya Anubhava is definitely there. Just like Drishya is outside, it is also there within. The Antakkarana, Sharira, Sula Sharira, these are all Drishya. Antakkarana emotions are cognized, you know. Therefore, there is some way, Sakshi Pratyaksha they are. Thereby, there is Atma and Anatma Bheda definitely there. Aumshadvayam is there. Nanu, Tatra Upalabhe Ityakaraka Pada Sahacharyad अस्य अंशद्वयोपलब्धिः केवल अहम् इत्यत्र कथम् इति चेन्न. नाउ द पूर्वपक्षी इज आस्किंग आई मेंट टू से दैट व्हेन यू से अहम् देर आर नो टू यूनिट सीन देर आर नो टू एंटिटी सीन यू आर गिविंग मी an example very smartly you are avoiding the question that I am asking. I asked you where are two entities when you say aham. You are showing me aham upalabhe. That aham upalabhe is not the question. The question is do you have an aham pratyaya at all? Do you have aham? That aham bhavana is there or not? When you say aham, just aham, aham asmi. Or in the utterance aham, the thought aham, there itself you show me two units. You are showing me with Drigdrishya Viveka and I know Drigdrishya Viveka. You show me with aham, where is the Drigdrishya Viveka, where are two entities. So padasacharyat, when you say upalabhe that tinganta pada, there is saukarya there. There is, you are using that to show two entities. With the example ayodhati also. Now you show me without that verb. Just show it with aham. Can you show me two entities? Kevala aham. So aushadvayo upalabdhi is there in aham upalabhi. I agree. Kevala aham ityatra katham iti chet. With kevala aham, just show me two entities. Kevala with just aham. Iti chet na. सिद्धांती सेज अहम पश्यामि अहम उपलभ्ये इत्येवं पदांतर साचर्येण एव धर्माध्यास विशिष्टत्वेन प्राथमिक धर्म्यध्यासस्य अनुभूतत्वात्. दिस धर्म्यध्यास अनुभव इज देयर ओनली थ्रू धर्माध्यास. देयरफॉर अनदर वर्ड इज नीडेड. यू नीड अ दृश्य. सम दृश्य हैज टू बी देयर फॉर the drik to be manifest as drik, atma to be manifest as drik or drashta. Shuddha atma cannot be known without a vritti, and vritti needs something else. Vritti has to be regarding something. If nothing else, there is tattvamasi mahavakya. That mahavakya will collapse onto oneself. The padadvaya will collapse onto oneself, but still you need padadvaya to start with. You cannot have one pada and nothing else to analyze with. There has to be at least a verb. Even with the aham inquiry, ko aham. So kaha aham kaha asmi. That kind of analysis should take place. Then only shabda bodha will take place. Then only the padas will culminate into brahmatma aikya. You cannot have upalabdhi of Shuddha Atma, inquiring into Shuddha Atma without the Antakkarana also. You need Antakkarana also. Therefore, there will always be Dharmadhyasa to know Dharmiyadhyasa on the Shuddha Atma. So there has to be some Dharmadhyasa. That is mentioned here. Therefore, I said Aham Upalabhe. Although you meant Kevala Aham, I also meant Kevala Aham. But Kevala Aham Adhyasa can be known only with the dharmadhyasa. Therefore, I brought in upalabhe, so it is not avoiding your question. I am not being over smart. Siddhanti says that I am answering your question in a way it can be answered. There is no other way to know. So, aham pashyami, aham upalabhe, these I see. I gain something, I cognize something. This all has to be the way to know the dharmiyadhyasa. Because dharma adhyasa is not possible without dharmi adhyasa. Even in the word aham, dharmi adhyasa has definitely taken place. That can be known with the dharma adhyasa as aham upalabhe, aham pashyami. Iti eva padantara sahacharyeneva. With the help of other words alone, dharma adhyasa vishishtatvena. Where there is a dharma adhyasa definitely known, through that prathamika dharmi adhyasa, the dharmi adhyasa aham, that is prathamika adhyasa, it has taken place before the Dvitiya Adhyasa as Aham Upalabhe, Aham Pashyami. So through the second, you infer that first has already taken place in the Kevala Aham. That is the idea. Therefore, Prathamika Dharmi Adhyasa, has already taken place, tasya anubhutatva, because there is anubhava. Nanu drishtanta darshtantikayoho katam shabdabodha iti chet. How will this shabdabodha take place? In the drishtanta that you have given, and in the ahodhati example, and in the aham upalabhi ityadi. Uchyate, if that is a question, the answer is given by the siddhanti ayodhati ityatra. In the example, ayodhati ityatra, dahati ityanena dagdhrutvam uchyate. By dahati dahana kriya, what has been talked about, what is mentioned is, what is intended is dagdhrutvam, the capacity to burn. Uchyate, ayodharmatvena, and that is what? That is agni dharma. Ayodharmatvena bhasamanasya dagdhrutvasya, that dagdhrutva, which is the agni dharma, which appears in ayas, ayaf pindaha, tasya ayodharmatva bhavat. It is not ayodharma at all. It is agni dharma. Therefore, what? It is an adhyasa. Agni tadatmya apanna ayaf pindaha ayas shabdena uchyate. With the ayas shabda, what is known is, what is intended in that example is that iron which has gained tadatmya sambandha with the agni. And dharmi adhyasa is there. How is it known? By ayodahati. Because dahana, that dagdhrutvam, is the agni dharma which is seen in ayaf pinda. So dharma adhyasa is there. With the dharma adhyasa, you know, as we have seen earlier, dharma adhyasa has been established as not being possible without dharmi adhyasa preceding. So dharma adhyasa is dharmi adhyasa purvakaha. Similarly, in that case, since the dharmi adhyasa can be inferred in the example case also by looking at the dharma adhyasa, in the exemplified also, it will be so. Tatha cha dagdhrutva vishishta agni tadatmya apanna ayaf pinda iti shabda bodha jayate. So what is the shabda bodha there? Dagdhrutva vishishta ayaf pinda, that is known in the cognition itself. This iron rod is what? It is having the capacity to burn. Dagdhrutva vishishta ayaf pinda. But what is that ayaf pinda? It cannot have dagdhrutva. It does not have dagdhrutva. Therefore, agni tadatmya apannaha, it is that ayaf pinda which has got tadatmya sambandha with the agni. Therefore, dharmi adhyasa is there that ayaf pinda burns which has got tadatmya sambandha as dharmi adhyasa, has dharmi adhyasa with the agni. That kind of iron rod is burning, meaning the burning capacity, dagdhrutvam, in the ayaf pinda is preceded. It is a dharma adhyasa there, because it isn't there, dagdhrutvam isn't there in the ayaf pinda, that dagdhrutvam cognized in the ayaf pinda is a dharma adhyasa. And it cannot be there without dharmi adhyasa, meaning ayaf pinda has got agni tadatmya. Therefore, agni tadatmya apannaha, it is that which has got ayaf pinda, which has got tadatmya sambandha, dharmi adhyasa with the agni. Iti shabda bodha jayate yatha. Similarly, in the darshtantika, tatha aham upalabhe ityatra upalabhe ityanena vritti rupa upalabdhir uchyate. Upalabhe means what? There is a vritti. There is a cognition with the vritti. So that is jnana taking place. I cognize something. What is that vritti rupa jnana? It is not chaitanya rupa jnana. It is not sarupa jnana. It is vritti rupa jnana. So vritti rupa upalabdhir uchyate. And there is a thing samanadhikarane with aham. The upalambhatvam, the upalabha is not the dharma of atma, but aham tadatmya sambandha is there. Therefore, that dharma adhyasa is taking place, meaning dharma adhyasa, the upalabdhi, vritti rupa upalabdhi, which is not there in atma, is seen in the atma aham because of dharmi tadatmya sambandha. So, spuranatmikayaha ahankara rupa jadadharmatvena bhasamanayaha vritti rupa upalabdehe jadadharmatva bhavad aham ityanena chittadatmya apanna ahankara uchyate. Now, this vritti, what is being said is that vritti rupa. So, it is the other way around. I explained it as with the perspective as aham. Aham upalabhe. There ahamka, when you say it is not chaitanya rupa, it is jada vritti. Jada vritti cannot really have any kind of cognition also. When I say cognition is taking place, shuddhatma cannot cognize and jada ahankara cannot cognize. So who is cognizing? It is a mithya entity which is a mix-up. Without that, there cannot be such prayoga also. So what is being done here is the vritti rupa upalabdhir ya uchyate. Spuranatmikaya ha ahankara rupa jada dharmatvena. So this purana, vritti spurana is taking place. Aham upalabhye. However, ahankara rupa, vritti is ahankara vritti. That ahankara is jada. Ahankara rupa jada dharmatvena bhasamanayaha. What is known to be jada? The vritti is jada. Tasyaha vrittehi, tasya ahankara rupa jada dharmatvena bhasamanayaha vritti rupa upalabdehe. That appears as a vritti. And vritti appears chetana. Vritti appears chetana, whereas ahankara is jada. So that is the way it is explained. Vritti appears because in vritti there is chit pratiphalana. There is a pratibimba. Chit pratibimba. So with that pratiphalana, the vritti becomes as though active. The bhana shows the sentience there. And then I say, I know. So what is taking place there? Ahankara cannot know. But then there is ahankara vritti of the form of I know. So there is some sentience. Jada cannot know. No ghata claims, no ghatapatadi claims as to I know. They cannot know. So what can know? Being bhautika, antakarana cannot know. But in antakarana there is this vritti which lights up as though knowing. So with that example, with that way the exemplified is explained. Vritti rupa upalabdhir uchyate spuranatmikayaha ahankara rupa jadadharmatvena bhasamanayaha vritti rupa upalabdhehe jadadharmatva bhavad. The vritti which has come up alive has no jadadharma anymore. It appears as though sentient. Therefore, there is some tadatmya with chaitanya. Ahamityanena chittadatmyapanna ahankara uchyate. तथा च उपलब्धि विशिष्टः चित्तादात्म्यापन्नः अहंकारः. सो शब्द बोध इज व्हाट अहंकार. आई हु एम एसोसिएटेड विद दिस अहंकार विज्ञानमय कोश. दैट इज व्हाट दिस अहंकार इज व्हाट अहम अहम अहम. दैट अहम इज एक्चुअली चित्तादात्म्यापन्नः. सो देयर इज अ चित्तादात्म्य वेयर बाय देयर इज this aham vritti has a claim, which is ahankara, nothing but ahankara. That has a claim. Aham is not really atma there. Aham is ahankara. Thereby the vritti rupa aham, not shuddha chidrupa aham, which cannot have a say as aham also. There is sentience, which is a brahma. Iti shabdabodha, shabdabodha. तस्माद् अहमित्यनेन दृग्दृश्य अंशद्वयम् अनुभूयते तथा सति साक्षिणी कूटस्थे कूटस्थले शुड बी कूटस्थ आई थिंक दृगांशस् स्वरूपे आत्मनि दृश्यांशस्य केवलस्य अहंकारस्य धर्मिणः अध्यास प्राथमिकः संभवति. सो धर्मी अध्यास हैज टू प्रिसीड द धर्माध्यास. As shown in the exemplified example, it is also in the exemplified. And therefore, what? Dharmadhyasa taking place. Chaitanya, seen where it isn't, is because of dharmi adhyasa preceding. And therefore, prathamika adhyasa is what? Dharmi adhyasa. So, drug and drishya, aunshadvaya are there, anubhava is there. And there is dharmi adhyasa also preceding, known through the dharma adhyasa. That is the शब्दबोधः एवम् अहंकारे अपि धर्मी स्वरूपात्मनः संसृष्टत्वेन अध्यास प्राथमिकः संभवति. सिमिलरली एवम् अहंकारे अपि, इन दि अहंकार आल्सो धर्मी स्वरूप आत्मनः, दि धर्मी आत्मा हैज गॉट धर्मी तादात्म्य अध्यास. सो संसृष्टत्वेन मीन तादात्म्य संबंधेन अध्यास प्राथमिकः संभवति. देयर इज अध्यास पॉसिबल धर्मी अध्यासमंतरा वृत्ति रूपोपलब्ध्यात्मक धर्माध्यासस्य असंभवाद इति भावः. दिस वृत्ति रूप अहम उपलब्धे दैट काइंड ऑफ वृत्ति रूप अध्यास विच इज धर्माध्यास दैट इज नॉट पॉसिबल विदाउट धर्मी अध्यास. देयरफॉर धर्मी अध्यास हैज टू बी टेकन एज द फर्स्ट अध्यास एंड एज पॉसिबल. भोग्य संघात शरीरादि संघात इत्यर्थः. सो व्हाट इज भोग्य संघात? भोग्य इज शरीरादि. शरीर आउटवर्ड इज नोन एज भोग्य बट शरीर इज ऑल्सो भोग्य. अत्र भाष्ये प्राथमिकाध्यासो न प्रतिपाद्यते किंतु अनंतराध्यास एव इति ज्ञापयितुं भागद्वयेन अर्थपूर्वकं अध्यासं विवृणोति. सो दिस इज द संगति टू दि अत्र अहमिदम् इत्यनेन इत्यादि. वी लुक एट दैट इन दि नेक्स्ट पार्ट. यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरि सहोदरापमहत्पदं तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकजाङ्कमनन्तसुखाकृतिं. नमस्ते. I'll see you in the next part.